Accused 9/11 recruiter Mohammed Haidar Zamar captured in northern Syria. So is this more proof that President Trump's strategy to take on terror is working? Joining me now is Israeli Special Forces veteran and founder of Aaron Cohen Security Training Systems, Aaron Cohen. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. We appreciate it.
Good morning, Heather.
So let's begin by Mohammed Haidar Zamar himself, what we know about him. He's a Syrian-born German national, right? He was an alleged recruiter of 9/11, a planner as well, and he was jailed for being a member of the Muslim Brotherhood. So how did we find him? What went down?
Well, originally the French agency or the French press agency reported that he was captured in Syria. And the reason why he was captured was because President Trump continues to press forward special operations in Syria. We've been there for the last couple of years. And in the last year in particular, we've gotten much more aggressive. And since this guy was captured, here it is. He's in his mid-50s. He's one of the original recruiters for the 9/11 terrorists. So this is a significant operation, both in terms of being able to close the door on that devastating attack on 9/11, but it also shows the continued failed policy of Merkel in Germany and how she's continuously let, you know, almost a million undocumented Muslims into her country. And what's happened is they fled to Syria like this guy. So he's Syrian-born, he's a German citizen, and who knows how many other hundreds of German citizens are running around Syria right now. But the good news is that we're there and we're in aggressive forward operations on the Syrian front. And this is going to ultimately affect our national security by reducing future attacks to us here in America.
And I wanted to
ask President Trump is doing the right thing.
Well, I wanted to ask you about that in terms of what President Trump is doing versus what Angela Merkel is doing in Germany and her immigration policies. What can be done to kind of meld the two? What does she need to do to assist and have the terrorism stop as well?
Well, she needs to stop letting in Muslims from terrorist-born nations, from nations that sponsor, that are actively involved in recruiting, that fund, that finance terrorism. That's number one. So her immigration policies are completely failed, and President Trump knows this wholeheartedly, and which is why he's not afraid to speak up and say it. Number two, Merkel needs to allow the United States and Israel and Britain to actively conduct inside intelligence operations in Germany to start listening to those phone calls so we can start generating warrants to begin to kick down doors overseas with those terrorists who have actively fled Germany. So intelligence is the key piece here. And the U.S., Israel, again, yeah, Britain, and other countries who have proper intelligence capabilities, start listening to those phone calls so we can start rooting out
and
other would-be potentials in those. Coordinating so that we can start getting those terrorist warrants and thwarting those attacks before they can
actualize. Before we run out of time, I want to ask you about this quickly, though. Iranian-backed militias apparently have set their sights on U.S. forces. There was this comment that went out over Facebook, so the Bakar Brigade, their threat. And these, what do we know about these Iranian-backed militias targeting
U.S.
forces?
Well, we know a lot more now in the last... We know a lot more now in the last couple of days since Israel's intelligence agency, Aman, or the Mossad, released several Iranian bases in Syria. They got hard intelligence that was released to the media to show that there's actually Iranian bases that are used to train and equip ISIS forces in Syria. And the reason why that information had to be put out there was that people know that Iran is actively a player in Syria. And so we've got the Bakir Brigade, which is just one of dozens of Iranian militias or terror organizations that are operating inside of Syria, struggling in that power vacuum. We need to go after these guys, take them down aggressively.
Well,
because
Aaron,
if we don't, we're going to see more of what we saw in Lebanon at the barracks in the early 80s.
And we don't
this goes
see
back
that.
A long time with these groups.
All right, Aaron, we're out of time, but thank you very much. We appreciate it. Important information this morning.
Thank you so much, Heather.